Sir Diva, thank you all. I think this is the first time I've got emotional while being interviewed, and that's because of the emotion of my late cousin and mentor Dharma Kumar, and even more of her uncle and her mentor, PLS K. Swaminathan. But I shall compose myself and come to the topic of my lecture today. I first met Sharda Prasad ji on 23rd April 1993. And I must confess that I remember this date, and I'm giving you the precise date this evening, not because of my prodigious memory or my historian's meticulousness, but because of Wikipedia. And I tell you, I'll explain the context. I first met Sharda Prasad ji, as Sanjeeva recalled, in GP's house, Deep Bar Safi's house, was one of the side roads leading up IIC. I also said in that piece, which I wish he had mentioned, that GP served the finest morav in Delhi. Morav should not be called buttermilk, it's just morav, it's not buttermilk. And in Delhi, around this time, you need morav. And I knew that that was, so it must have been roughly early summer. And then I recalled GP saying, today is Gopal's 70th birthday. Gopal being Sarvepalli Gopal. So I went to Wikipedia and I found out, and I first met Sharda Prasad on 23rd April 1993 at GP's house. And he talked very little. He was a reticent man, especially at first meeting. And I then got to know him only 3 or 4 years later. Sandeeva did me the kind honor of calling me an independent historian. Independent in my views, I'll accept that compliment. I think I've written the odd ghost-written piece, not as many as Sharda Prasad ji, but I've written the odd ghost-written piece. But I've written only one piece as somebody else's guest. Every piece I have written is because I want to write it. Even though my wife, my son, my best friend, my editor all tell me not to write it. But I've only written one, so to say, commissioned piece. This was in about 1996, when Gopal Gandhi told me, Ram, M.S. Subbalakshmi must get the Bharat Ratna. But you must write about it. And these are the reasons why she should get it. But I am secretary to the president, so I can't write it. And you must explain A, B, C, D, what her music is, what her character is, how the Bharat Ratna has been contaminated and polluted by politicians who give it to fellow politicians, and why great musicians need it. And since this is Delhi, if you say only M.S. Subbalakshmi used to get the Bharat Ratna, you will be called elitist. You should say, M.S. Subbalakshmi and Lata Mangeshkar did both get the Bharat Ratna. So he essentially told me the whole piece to write. And I added, I wrote it along in my name, in a Delhi magazine then was, which was then widely read before internet and cable TV shifted to discourse elsewhere. And I added on my own, along with, the one line was my own. I mean, the words were my own, but the thoughts were all Gopal Gandhi's. And I added on my own, apart from M.S. Subbalakshmi and Lata Mangeshkar, Bismillah Khan and Ravi Shankar should also get the Bharat Ratna, so that will be more music and be north, south, east and west. Now, of course, much later all four got the Bharat Ratna. But after I wrote this piece, Gopal Gandhi sent me a letter. That's not enough. Now you must solicit the help of Sharda Prasad ji in your campaign, because he has much more influence than you or me combined. And he's in Delhi, and people regard him with respect, and he wrote a wonderful and widely read column in the Asian Age. So wrote him a letter, saying, dear Sharda Prasad ji, I know you saw my article in India Today, but at that stage, by the way, I was just following Gopal Gandhi's instructions. I did not know the music connection, which should be told, which he, Sandeeva, has not mentioned. Sharda Prasad and Mohan Ram's father was a great composer of classical music, and there is actually, I'm told, a CD of treatises composed by him, sung by MS. So I didn't know that because
Wikipedia doesn't have.
Huh?
Because Wikipedia.
No, Wikipedia. Then there was no Wikipedia. I didn't know that because I'm more Hindustani music person myself. But I should have known it. But I just wrote a Sharda Prasad. Yeah, I like this column in Asian Age. And I said, so he took it up and he wrote in his column that although MS Subbalakshmi has already been dignified a jewel of India by the public, maybe still, you know, to redeem ourselves and so on. That's the start of our friendship. He would then come to Bangalore every summer to escape the torrid heat. We would converse about the things that Sandeeva has talked about. We would never talk about Indira Gandhi. For various reasons, I never brought it up. Because there was so much else to talk about. I mean, there was music, there was literature, there was music, there was history, there was Karnataka, there was Gandhi, there was Harilal Gandhi. Here's an extraordinary story about Harilal Gandhi, Gandhi's estranged son, who came into his office on the day Gandhi died, when he was working for Goenka before he started working for Nehru, and so on. But I just say one, I'll end this personal recollection of my acquaintanceship. I won't call it a friendship, I would call it, a series of maybe 8 or 10 meetings over 8 or 10 years, which deeply enriched me. And of course, in between reading his wonderful weekly column in the Asian Age, by one line which I feel captured the man, you know, his rectitude and integrity, which has been mentioned, the rectitude maybe even before the integrity. The book I won't be writing other essays is, the title is an allusion to the fact that he never wrote his memoirs, even though he worked with 3 prime ministers. And he was once asked privately why he didn't do it. He said, it's easy for a man to become a ghost, but it's impossible for a ghost to become a man again. But I think he would have abhorred cashing in on that proximity. I mean, unlike some of his fellow occupants of the prime minister's office, who have gone on to name, fame, notoriety, wealth, whatever it will be, he would not write his memoirs. And this was the most exquisite reply was this. Not that I'm a person of rectitude and integrity, and I don't want to breach confidence, but it's impossible for a ghost to become a man again. So instead he put his prodigious learning and humanity and humor into his columns, which have been collected in, I believe, 1 volume in English, 3 or 4 in Kannada, and hopefully there'll be more.